welcome to ¿Qué Pasa? This is Norma Rodriguez Reyes, your host. You'll be able to listen to us via La Voz Radio TV, New Haven, that's our Facebook, and you're listening to us via WNHHLP 103.5 FM and live streaming via the newhavenindependent.org and lavozradiotv.com. We have here live in our studio audience Captain, the chief of the New Haven Police Department, Chief Anthony Campbell. Thank you, Chief,
Thank you for
being here with
me.
Us.
I appreciate being here.
And then we also have with us Assistant Chief Otoniel Reyes.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. Thank you.
Thank you for being here with us. And we also have with us Sergeant Manmet Colon. That was a tongue twister, Manmet.
That is a tongue twister.
Is it Manmet?
It's Manit.
Manit. Thank you so much for being here.
It's French name.
Now, why do you think I have the chief, the assistant chief, and the sergeant here in our live, in our studio audience? Because do you want to be a police officer? The New Haven Police Department is now hiring, and you'll be able to submit your application from June 5th to the 23rd of this month, and time is running out. So please, if you wish to apply, you need to do so in policeapp.com. Now, if you haven't decided whether you want to be a police officer or not, we have with us three very committed individuals to this great city and to the position in which they hold very sacredly. And they would like to explain to you some of the reasons why you should consider being a police officer. And for those that are not of age yet or are over age, then you might still want this information because you might have someone close to you that you think would make an excellent police officer. So let's first start with our chief.
Yes, ma'am.
Who just recently the city of New Haven went through a serious search for a new chief, and the person who they chose, who they felt out of all the applicants was the most qualified to run the New Haven Police Department, Anthony Campbell.
Thank you, ma'am. I appreciate it.
So, Anthony, tell us a little bit about why did you become a police officer?
Well, I became a police officer. Originally, I came up here to go to Yale, and I thought I was going to be a priest. But my second year, God led me to the woman who is now my wife. So I said, well, I'm not going to be a priest, but I still want to do something where I feel like I can be involved in people's lives and kind of minister to them. And policing is that medium for me. It gives me the opportunity to connect with other human beings when they are in crisis, when they are their most vulnerable, and when they are looking for some outside source of assistance to come in and try and level life out and get them back on track. And in many ways, that's exactly what being a police officer means to me. It means that in many ways, I get to live out my faith by helping others, serving others. And if you talk to the bulk of most police officers and you ask them why they want to be a police officer, most of them will say, because I really want to help others or help my community. So it's a great opportunity, and that's what we're looking for.
It's definitely not for the pay, right?
Oh, it's not for the pay. Trust me, it's not for the pay.
You don't become a millionaire being a police officer.
No, you do not. You don't. I mean,
but you get to help a lot of people.
You get to help a lot of people. You really do. And it does provide an opportunity where you can sustain a family, save for the future, because it does have a pension and a 401k type of plan, have good health care. But you really get to make a difference in your community. And it's one of the most rewarding professions, I think, on the face of the earth.
Thank you so much. Mm-hmm. Assistant Chief Otoniel Reyes,
yes.
Tell us why, out of all the professions that you could have chosen, why a police officer?
Well, you know, I'd like to say that I didn't choose a profession. The profession chose me. Mm-hmm. I am a resident of the city. I was born and raised in the city. Mm-hmm. And lived in New Haven all my life, went to public schools in New Haven. I actually wanted to go into the legal field. I wanted to be an attorney. I started right out of college working with people with drug addiction. Mm-hmm. And also I was a part-time EMT. And my goal was to save money and to start going to college and to go to college to law school. The application came out for the police department. I had a good friend of mine that was a police officer and encouraged me to do so. And again, I think that it was just in God's plan. I put the application in, and from that point forward, it became a passion, and I realized very soon after, and certainly now, that it was the best decision I ever made. So,
How long have you been in the police force?
18 years.
18 years. Very good. Well, now, Sergeant Colon, why did you become a police officer? When, especially, you know, as a Latina, okay, it's not fashionable to be a police officer.
So I'll go into that since you mentioned I'm a Latina. I'm actually, my husband is Puerto Rican, but I was born in India, raised there until I was 11. Then I came to the United States when I was 11 years old. My parents migrated to Queens, New York. And if you know of Queens, New York, there are a lot of Indians there. So I grew up in New York for up until 2003 when I decided to come to college, and I went to UNH. While at UNH, I was very intrigued by the investigative side of policing. Lo and behold, when I came to the police department, when I got to do some assignments in the bureau, I think I enjoyed more of the community aspect than the investigative side. I do enjoy that, but just talking to people and having people come up to you and ask questions and knowing that you may have made a difference in someone's life by just answering one simple question and going around and people introducing their kids. Oh, look, there's a police officer. I mean, that right there means a lot to me more than anything in the world. So yeah. That's the reason why.
Well, folks, you've heard now why are the three distinguished individuals that we have here have decided on the profession of police officer. Now, tell us about the recruiting that you're doing, Chief.
So we are reaching out to the community, particularly the New Haven community. We really want to try and get New Haven residents to take an interest in becoming police officers. New Haven residents are given 10 additional points on the exam because we value New Haven residents being officers and having a vested interest in policing this city. So we're going out everywhere. We've got billboards up. We've been on social media. We're hitting the airwaves. We are hitting the churches, schools, anywhere and everywhere so that we can get this message out that we're hiring. Anyone who's 21 years of age, has a valid driver's license, high school diploma or GED. We're looking for people of good moral character. And, you know, you can't have any felony convictions or class A or B misdemeanor convictions.
Can you elaborate a little bit on those two? Because
sure.
I know I was looking at them, but I didn't know what you were talking about in terms of, you know, the felony. What is a felony and what is a class A and class B?
So a felony is a crime where if you are convicted of it, you serve more than a year. So anything that is less than a year would be a misdemeanor. Anything that you'd be convicted where you'd have to serve more than a year is what we call a felony. It's a classification within the criminal justice system. So also within the misdemeanor system, so that's something that's less than a year, you have different classifications. And allow you to carry a firearm, and of course as a police officer you'd have to carry a firearm. Anyone who would have been convicted of a class A or B felony misdemeanor would know that that's exactly what it was, and anyone who had to serve more than a year knows that they've been convicted of a felony. One thing we do encourage people who may have had some negative interactions with law enforcement or the criminal justice system in the past is that there is a pardon system, and if you are someone who's gone through and been pardoned, we encourage you, if you want to be a police officer, please apply with our department. We want everyone to go to policeapp.com, and if it's not something that you're interested in, but you know a family member, a friend, someone in the community you think would be a good officer, send them our way. And something earlier, I know that you had said that, you know, if people are too old, the great thing about our department is that as long as you're 21 years of age, you know, some departments, I know many people will say, well, I'm over 38, I can't do it. We don't have upper age limits. Our contract does require us to retire by age 67, but we've had many people in their early to mid-50s come on the job, go through the academy, and are some of the most fantastic police officers you can ever imagine because they've got good life experience.
Okay. Now, one of the reasons why I also thought it would be a good idea if you come onto this show is as a basically trying to reach out to the minorities.
Yes.
You know that life is not easy when you grow up in the inner city.
Yes.
And especially if you have issues in your home.
Yes.
And so I believe that there has been some kids that just haven't had a fair break from the day they were born.
Absolutely.
And so maybe some of them, you know, were, their lifestyle mm-hmm. as they were growing up was bad, but mm-hmm. they've changed.
Yes.
And, you know, many of us that are religious believe mm-hmm. that, you know, one can turn over a new leaf.
Absolutely.
And become a... So the only alternative would be to ask for a pardon in order for them to go into the police department, right?
Yes.
For them.
If they have a Class A or B conviction or a felony conviction, the only way to really clear that up is to go through the pardon process.
Okay.
It's a lengthy process, but many people are going through it. Since 2013, the numbers have skyrocketed because people, our society is recognizing that we really want to give people a second chance.
Okay. You know, we're trying to reach out for the New Haveners because I know that a lot of the recruits happen to be from the suburbs.
Yes.
Or from other towns, and the city of New Haven is investing in them, and then they end up leaving.
Yes.
And not as committed to the city than if they lived here in the city.
Mm-hmm.
I was wondering if there's any way that you guys would consider taking the students from the eighth grade,
mm-hmm.
because if you start them, the African Americans and the Latinos and just anyone that really has experienced the inner city life, because mm-hmm. the inner city life, you grow up with multicultural, and you all of these folks become family.
Yes.
But people who have not been exposed to a multicultural life, it's not easy for them.
Got it.
To mainstream all of a sudden.
Exactly.
So if in the school system, the New Haven public school system, if they had a program from eighth grade, not after they graduate from high school, it's
correct.
Too late.
Correct.
But if you have them to train them to be police officers, to begin the mindset and everything, obviously you can't do the guns and all
right.
that other stuff. But I really believe that that would be a big help to our inner cities.
I agree with you. And one great thing is that we have the early stages of a program like that. It's called the Public Safety Academy. It's right over at Hill House. It's both police and fire. And we start with kids right at that age range, right at the eighth grade, freshman year, because we really need to help them understand that what you do now will affect you in the future. We also try to get them involved in what we have in the police department called our Explorers Program. So that's for youth who are ages 13 and up. The Explorers Program basically exposes them to everything that we do as a police officer. They meet on a weekly basis, they have uniforms, they have responsibilities, there is a command structure system to help them maintain that mindset so that as they go through their early years in high school and go off to college, that they will maintain that mindset so that when they hit 21 and they return to the community, that they would be perfect candidates. Now, what we're trying to do is expand these programs so that instead of it just being in one school, it could be in all the schools. Because
right.
I think you're right. If we start at the eighth grade level and have this done, it'll really help.
That definitely, you know, we wouldn't have to work so hard.
Exactly.
Or spend all this money recruiting.
Correct. Because we already have people in the pipeline who would be ready to go right into the academy.
That's a
yeah.
wonderful idea.
Yeah.
Now, Chief, can you explain to us, like, when you come in as a police, you know, what are the requirements?
Sure.
First, what are the requirements? And then when you come in as a police officer, and how do you go up the ladder?
So ultimately, you have to be 21 years of age. You have to have a high school diploma or GED. You have to be a U.S. citizen. You have to be a person who doesn't have any felony convictions or a Class A or B misdemeanors. And we're looking for people of good moral character. You've got a good background. So you take the fill in the application at policeapp.com. Then ultimately what you'll do is you'll be notified of your testing date. You start out with an agility test, which requires you to do running, sit-ups, push-ups, sit and reach. You also then, if you pass that portion, you move on to a written exam. Then there's an oral exam. You get a combined score from your written and your oral. And that's why if you're a New Haven resident or you have military, that helps you because you get 10 points for being a New Haven resident, 5 points for military. which can be added on top of your combined score. After that process, we do what's called a background investigation. Background investigators check everything from, you know, where you work, your school, all of that. And then after that process, what we do is psychological exam, polygraph exam, medical exam, and one more time where you do the agility. Then you enter the academy.
You know, Chief,
it's a long process.
Yeah, but you know what's very interesting about this long process? This wasn't so years ago.
That's right.
Years ago much when other folks controlled the department, right, it was easy to get in.
Yep.
Now when all of a sudden we can get into the process, all the hurdles.
A lot of hoops to jump through.
Yes, a lot of hoops. And that's not fair.
Yeah. And then once you get on the job, you come on as an officer. You have to be an officer for a minimum of 3 years before you could start looking into doing testing. After that period, you could test for detective. After 4 years, I believe, you can test for sergeant. And so the sergeant is the next available rank. You would then be a sergeant for 3 to 4 years, and then you could test for the next rank, which is lieutenant. After lieutenant, we have captains. After captains, we still have on our books a major. And then after that, you would go to the next rank, which is assistant chief, and then chief.
No general.
He's the general.
The chief is the equivalent of a general.
He's the general. Definitivamente.
Yeah. Yes.
That, you know, how's the recruiting coming along?
It's coming along pretty well. We have well over 500 applicants. We are hoping to break the 1,000 mark, because one of the things you find when you're doing recruiting is that for every 100 people, you may be able to get 10. Because once you go through the screening process, the background process, some people can't pass the agility, medical. So it's important. The more people you get, the more qualified candidates you will get.
And how many are you looking to hire?
We are looking right now. We have a budget of the maximum strength of the police department is 495 officers. Currently, we have 442. So we're looking to get a class of 40 to 45 in by the end of this year. But we also have a lot of people who can retire over the next year, year and a half. So realistically, over the next year, year and a half, we're looking to do over 100 officers. Yeah. So that's why we encourage people to apply now, because there's a great opportunity. Whereas other smaller departments may hire one or two, we're looking for 40, 45 people at a time, which gives you a greater chance of being selected.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
Now, once they get on this list, is this list?
This list is good for 1 year, but we always extend it out to about 2 years. So if you get on the list, it's good for about 2 years. So if you're on the list, you have a really good chance of being hired as a police officer.
Well, I want to take this opportunity and thank you so much for being here.
And
¿qué pasa? I want to wish you the best.
Thank you.
Hope you get. And I know that you're going to reach your goal, and I know that new great officers are going to be out there, because, like the chief said, it's definitely a calling. Our assistant chief, you've heard them, the reason why they decided. And if you're really interested in helping mankind, I think this is an excellent profession to be able to do that. So thank you all for listening, and we'll be right back with this program in Spanish. Until next time, this is Norma Rodriguez-Reyes, your host in ¿Qué Pasa? And you've been listening to WNHH 103.5 FM, live stream via the NewHavenIndependent.org and LaVozRadioTV.com. Until next time, have a nice day. Bye. We'll be right back.
Transmite en su canal de frecuencia modulada estereofónica multiplex, lavozradiotv.com, en duplex con WNHH 103.5 FM New Haven, Connecticut. Y ahora usted tiene la oportunidad de ver a Norma Rodríguez Reyes en su programa ¿Qué pasa? Pero ahora en español, y tenemos invitados de lujo. Tenemos al jefe de la policía de New Haven, el Chief Anthony Campbell, y también tenemos a Otoniel Reyes, asistente chief de las operaciones, y con ellos la sargento Manette Colón, que está trabajando con el reclutamiento, y como siempre nuestra estimadísima locutora estrella Norma Rodríguez Reyes. Buenas tardes, Norma, ¿cómo estás?
Buenas tardes, quiero darle las gracias a todos ustedes que están sintonizados aquí en esta emisora. Como mencionó Di Palma, tenemos con nosotros hoy aquí al jefe de la policía, Anthony Campbell, y él recientemente ha sido jurado como jefe de la policía, so es un nuevo jefe de la policía. Queremos que todos sepan que tenemos un nuevo jefe de la policía, así que si algún día ustedes tuvieron una mala, tú sabes, no muy buena experiencia con la policía, olvídense, porque ahora tenemos un nuevo jefe, tenemos más policías constantemente que están más vinculados con la comunidad, que pueden en realidad asistir a las personas que necesitan la ayuda del departamento de policía. La razón por la cual tenemos al jefe de la policía aquí es porque están reclutando. So, si usted quiere ser un policía, por favor escuche, porque le vamos a poder decir todo lo que necesita para poder solicitar para ser un policía.
¿Quieres ser policía? ¿Sí? El Departamento de Policía de New Haven está contratando del 5 de junio al 23 de junio del 2017 nuevos agentes. Solicite su aplicación en policeapplication.com. Debe tener, ser mayor de 21 años, antes del 1 de octubre, tiene que tener diploma de la Escuela Superior High School o GED, debe ser ciudadano de los Estados Unidos, tener licencia de conducir válida sin tener delitos y sin haber cometido ningún delito clase A o clase B, y no ha sido condenado por violencia doméstica. Se le añade puntos si usted es veterano o vive en New Haven. Norma.
Gracias, muchas gracias por esa información. Bueno, antes de continuar hablando sobre solicitar para ser policía, yo quisiera que ustedes escucharan el por qué nuestro jefe de la policía decidió que él quería ser policía. Y también nuestro asistente jefe nos va a dejar saber por qué él también decidió ser policía. Y nuestra sargenta Colón también nos va a decir por qué ella decidió ser policía. Ok, jefe. Why did you decide to become a police officer?
Now you know it. I can't do Spanish. Will you translate?
You're going to translate?
Sure.
Okay.
Okay. Or you can translate.
Okay. You translate.
You want me to?
Okay. Yes.
Okay. I decided to become a police officer because...
Decidí ser un policía, ¿por qué?
When I came to Connecticut, I planned on being a priest.
Cuando llegué al estado de Connecticut, tenía planes de ser un ministro.
But God had other plans.
Pero Dios tenía otros planes.
So when I graduated, I wanted to do something where I could help people.
Cuando me gradué, quería hacer algo que para ayudar personas, otras personas.
And I realized that policing is a job where you can help people on an everyday basis.
Y me di de cuenta que ser un policía es un trabajo que puedes ayudar a la gente todos los días.
And that's why I became a police officer.
Y esa es la razón que...
Bueno, ¿escucharon eso? De ministro a policía. So, si algún día usted no puede ser ministro, quería ser un ministro, no se preocupe, porque Dios sabe cuál es el plan para ti. Así mismito como hizo con el jefe de la policía, Anthony Campbell. Ok, asistente, jefe, ¿por qué decidiste tú ser policía?
Gracias, Norma. Bueno, a mí me gusta decir que el trabajo me eligió a mí. Soy nacido en la ciudad de New Haven. Soy hijo de New Haven, fui a la escuela pública en New Haven, y el deseo mío siempre era ser abogado. Empecé fuera del colegio a hacer trabajos para para ganar más dinero, para ir a la escuela de abogacía, y un amigo me dio información que la policía de New Haven estaba reclutando. Y no lo pensé mucho, decidí hacerlo, y fue la mejor decisión que yo hice. So, el mensaje que les quiero decir a los que están oyendo, que quizás nunca pensaron que la profesión, el trabajo de policía era para ellos, fue la mejor decisión que yo hice. He estado como policía por 18 años y ha sido un trabajo que me ha dado más a mí que lo que yo le he dado al trabajo.
Bueno, ¿escucharon ustedes eso? Aunque no pudo ser abogado, pero yo estoy más que seguro que está siendo bastante, mucho abogado ahí siendo policía. Porque siempre uno, lo que uno siempre anhela, de una manera u otra lo hace en el trabajo en el cual uno ha escogido o te ha escogido a ti. Ok, Sargenta Colón, ¿por qué tú decidiste ser policía?
Well, I was born in India, raised there until the age of 11.
Fui nacida en India y me crié ahí hasta los 11 años.
And went to high school in Queens, New York. Went to college at UNH in West Haven.
Fui a la escuela en Queens, Nueva York. Y después fui al colegio en la Universidad de New Haven.
I was always intrigued by investigations until I actually joined the department.
Siempre estuve atraída a las investigaciones hasta que llegué hasta el departamento de policía.
And realized that I enjoy the community aspect of policing, knowing that I can help someone and make a difference in someone's life.
Hasta que llegué al departamento y me di de cuenta que sentía más satisfacción trabajando con la comunidad y hacer diferencia en la vida de la gente.
Bueno, ya ustedes escucharon, ¿ok? De un ministro, de un abogado y de un investigador. Y los tres son policías, ¿ok? Sí, en rangos bastante altos, pero ellos empezaron como policía primero, ¿ok? So, ahora vamos a hablar qué es lo que se necesita para uno ser policía. Chief Campbell, tell us, what is it necessary in order for one to become a police officer?
So, you have to be 21 years of age.
So, necesitas ser de 21 años.
You have to have a high school diploma or GED.
Tienes que tener un diploma de escuela secundaria o GED.
You have to be a citizen of the United States.
Tiene que ser ciudadano de los Estados Unidos.
You have to have a valid driver's license.
Tiene que tener una licencia de conducir válida.
And you have to have no felony convictions or class A or B misdemeanor convictions.
Y no puede tener condenas de delitos mayores o delitos menores de clasificación A o B.
Bueno, ya ustedes escucharon cuáles son las cualificaciones si es que está interesado en ser policía. Y como hemos mencionado, en estos momentos se están aceptando las solicitudes para ser policía hasta el día 23. Y ustedes pueden ir a policeapp.com. Police, P-O-L-I-C-E, app. Com. Ahí es donde ustedes pueden ir en línea y buscar la solicitud y solicitar para esta posición. Ok.
Ahí está en pantalla, Norma.
Sí. Los que están viendo a través de lavozradiotv.com pueden ver, ok, la... Y esto ha estado en todos los sitios para que las personas, obviamente ha estado en el periódico La Voz Hispana, que vamos también a hablar sobre la venida aquí a los radios del jefe y del asistente jefe de la sargenta, para que ustedes vean que ellos están extendiendo la mano y buscando personas que tienen pasión. Okay, para que sean policía. Y es una buena profesión. Obviamente no se convierte en un millonario, okay, pero están ayudando a las personas. Can you now tell us, once you get into the police department,
yes,
what are the different the different steps
sure.
that one gets to.
Sure.
Vamos a hablar de los diferentes rangos en la cual eres aceptado como policía y cuáles son los diferentes rangos y qué tiempo va a tomar para llegar eventualmente a ser jefe de la policía. Uh-huh. No durante este tiempo, porque el jefe no está interesado en dar su posición, sino en 20 años de aquí, ¿ok? No.
So, when you graduate from the academy, you are what we call a certified police officer.
Cuando se gradúa de la academia, usted es lo que llamamos un oficial certificado.
So, la academy, how long?
The academy runs for approximately 28 weeks, so pretty much 7 months.
So, la academia corre por más o menos 28 semanas, como si desea 7 meses.
And you get paid during the academy. That's important.
Sí, y recibe un pago durante ese tiempo.
¿Ustedes escucharon eso? Usualmente, cuando uno va a la universidad, 4 años de universidad, uno tiene que pagar. Sin embargo, después que ustedes salgan de la escuela superior, pueden ir, si tienen 21 años, o lo van a cumplir en octubre 1, pueden ir a la academia si son aceptados y ellos le pagan a ustedes. Eso no sucede en muchos trabajos. Okay.
Then, once you're an officer for 4 years, you can take a civil service exam for the rank of sergeant.
Y cuando cumpla 4 años de ser empleado como oficial, entonces es elegible para tomar un examen civil para el rango de sargento, que es el primer nivel de supervisión.
Okay.
After you are a sergeant for approximately 4 years, you can take an exam to be a lieutenant.
Después que esté en el rango de sargento por aproximadamente 4 años, tiene la oportunidad de tomar un examen para ser teniente de la policía, que es el segundo rango de supervisión.
And then after you're a lieutenant for 3 years, you can take an exam for the position of captain.
Después de ser un teniente por 3 años, entonces es elegible para tomar otro examen para la posición de capitán.
The next rank is the rank of major.
El próximo rango es el rango de mayor.
And then assistant chief.
Y después asistente jefe.
And ultimately chief.
Y últimamente el jefe.
Bueno, como vieron ya, tenemos 6 diferentes posiciones y cada vez que reciben esas posiciones, también es aumento de salario, ¿verdad que sí? With every single step you go up, it's also an increase in salary.
Absolutely.
And Norma, another position we missed in there
major
is the detective.
Detective.
You also have an opportunity to take a detective test, and
yes.
I think that's after 2 years or three?
Three years.
Bueno, ya ustedes escucharon que pueden seguir subiendo constantemente si ese es su deseo. Aunque yo creo que, si no me equivoco, muchos han decidido quedarse como policía, ¿verdad? Muchos se quedan por mucho tiempo.
Sí, lo que encontramos es que en el departamento, especialmente en New Haven, una de las ventajas que tenemos es que hay tantas oportunidades que los oficiales típicamente encuentran lo que le gusta hacer. Algunos le gustan ser investigadores de narcóticos, algunos le gustan trabajar con la violencia doméstica, con el delito de homicidio, y hay muchas oportunidades. O diferentes oficiales, dependiendo la pasión que desarrollan en el trabajo, se mantienen. Algunos son oficiales de carrera y le encanta trabajar en la calle como oficiales y se mantienen así por muchos años.
Bueno, como ya ustedes han oído, el propósito de esto es para reclutar policías. Entonces, hemos estado hablando de que hay una falta de policías minoritarios, afroamericanos y latinos. Le hacen falta para aquí, para la ciudad. El jefe me estaba contando de que hay programas que se han establecido desde que en el octavo grado, ¿ok? Nosotros queremos que ustedes escuchen bien y busquen esos programas si les interesa ser policía. Porque le voy a preguntar al jefe cuál es el programa y a dónde es que se encuentra. Chief, you were telling me that in the 8th grade, you already have programs so that we can recruit minorities from the inner city. Can you Tell me one more time so that our listeners could...
It's our public safety program, which is a program which is set up in Hill House High School. It currently is only at that school, and it encompasses both the police and the fire department. But we're working to try and expand it so that it will ultimately be in all schools. The difficulty is, of course, there's some finances to it because there are classes and there are people who are trying to keep these kids on track. Then there's also our Explorers program, which is a police department program where we have approximately 18 young people from ages 13 through 18 who participate in a program which is like a miniature police program where they have different ranks, responsibilities, they go on ride-alongs. They understand we teach them everything that we do so that they can be in the mindset of what it is to be a police officer.
And this Explorer is where?
That's held right at the Police Academy, 710 Sherman Parkway.
Okay.
Pues, como dice el jefe, tenemos ciertos programas que corren de la escuela de Hill House, específicamente en este momento estamos buscando expandir estos programas, pero ahora... tenemos un programa en Hill House que está dirigido para los muchachos que están en la escuela secundaria para ayudarlos a empezar a familiarizarlos con el departamento de policía y también el departamento de bomberos para servicios públicos y los ayudan a empezar a entender los requisitos de esos programas y qué tienen que hacer ellos para prepararse para tener una carrera en el futuro. Y primordialmente el propósito es para mantenerlos motivados y para también estar seguro que darle apoyo para que no vayan por carreras que le pueda después hacer daño para poder tener estas posiciones. También tenemos un programa de exploradores, que eso es algo que hacemos por el departamento directamente para niños, muchachos de 13 a 18 años. Y es un programa que policías en el departamento que tienen entrenamiento especial para trabajar con este grupo, los enseñan, los llevan a diferentes parques, los llevan a diferentes actividades, le enseñan ciertas calidades para que desarrollen como humanos y también como gente de carácter y de moral y últimamente como gente que puedan ser policías en la ciudad.
Gracias. Bueno, como ustedes han escuchado, okay, el proceso de aplicación está abierto en estos momentos hasta el día 23 de junio y puede solicitar en línea policeapp.com. Y para los que están en el octavo grado, por favor, si lo que quieren ser es policía o bombero, busquen el programa de Hill House High School que se llama The Public Safety Program. O también, si le interesa, busquen también el programa de Explorers que el Departamento de Police Department ofrece. Tienen en estos momentos 18 estudiantes que escogen de entre la edad de 13 a 18, ¿ok? Para dejarles saber todo sobre el Departamento de Policía. Queremos darle las gracias en estos momentos. Inafortunadamente, el tiempo nos traiciona constantemente y nos tenemos que despedir prontito, pero antes de despedirnos quería hablar con el jefe y preguntarle si hay algo que él quisiera hablar. Chief, unfortunately this time really is a traitor, okay? and it's running so fast, but before I finish, I wanted to say if there's anything that you would like to say at this time.
Sure. I just want to encourage anyone out there who's thinking about becoming a police officer or knows someone who wants to do it. We have revamped the entire process to make it a lot more palatable for anyone who's a resident, particularly minorities, to come and become part of this family. So if you're thinking about doing it, put the application in and come join us.
So el jefe quiere exhortar a todos los oyentes que estamos enfocando mucho en invertir en la ciudad de New Haven, en nuestros ciudadanos. Y hemos hecho el proceso mucho más posible para que los que son ciudadanos tengan ventajas y puedan tener oportunidades para servir su comunidad. Y estamos muy excitados en la oportunidad de tener más gente de la ciudad de New Haven ser parte del departamento.
Gracias. Colón, is there anything that you would like to say?
Just a few things before we end the show. So there is a physical ability test that will take place, and it's important for people to pass that test in order to move forward with the written process. So also, we made available some agility clinics, what we're calling them. If someone needs help with the physical ability test, which is a little strenuous, but with our help, we can lead them to the right direction at least. So tomorrow, Saturday, mm-hmm. we have a physical ability clinic at Bowen Field Track next to Hill House High School, 480 Sherman Parkway. It's from 10 to 12:30. We'll have a track coach, and we will have two instructors from the academy that will teach them how to properly perform a sit-up and push-ups, and show them how to do the 300, at least show them how to do the 300-meter sprint and a mile-and-a-half run. A few days ago, we had a physical ability clinic. We had about 30-plus people that were there, and they all needed the help. So we encourage people to please take advantage of these events that we have coming up, and we will have these clinics Wednesdays at 5 p.m., 5 to 7:30 at Bowen Field, Saturday, 10 a.m. to 12:30 at Bowen Field as well, up until July 5th, which is the Wednesday prior to the agility test. The agility test is July 8th and 9th, written test is July 15th, and the oral test is July 22nd, July 23rd. And it's important for people to remember these dates. It's the summertime, so if they have vacation, if they really want this, they have to make it.
Now, where would this information be available to them?
All this information is available on our website, cityofnewhaven.com, police department link. If they go into recruitment page, everything is there. Okay. Not only that, we have a Facebook account, which is New Haven Police Department Recruitment Team. We have Instagram, NHPD Recruitment, Twitter, NHPD Recruitment. We are constantly updating all this information on there. Also, the applicant handbook, which is available at policeapp.com. It is a lengthy handbook, but we strongly urge you to read this because it has a lot of information in there. Also, for the physical ability test, the day of the test, whoever's taking the test, the applicant has to bring a medical approval form at the test site. If they do not have one, they will be turned around. They have to bring a signed medical form to the test site.
To go to the Bowen Field, do they need to register beforehand, or can they just show up?
When they go for the physical ability workshop, they do not need to register. All they need to do is send an email to nhpdrecruitment@newhavenct.gov. nhpdrecruitment@newhavenct.gov. This way we know how many people are going to show up. We have not turned around anyone yet. And it's been so far with just one clinic, all those people are coming back for tomorrow's clinic as well.
That's wonderful. Well, I want to take this opportunity and thank you very much for being here.
Le quiero dar,
tú sabes, esto es muy bueno que ellos han hecho, inafortunadamente el tiempo tan cortito, pero esto es bueno que el jefe, el asistente jefe y la sargenta han venido aquí para explicar el proceso en cómo hacerse policía. En estos momentos yo quiero darle las gracias por haber estado escuchando y hasta la próxima. Se despide de nosotros Norma Rodríguez Reyes en ¿Qué pasa?
Hasta aquí el programa ¿Qué pasa? Recuerde, el Departamento de Policía de New Haven está reclutando, señoras y señores. Del 5 de junio al 23 de julio del 2017, solicite su aplicación en policeapp.com. Para aplicar debe ser mayor de 21 años de edad. Antes del 1 de octubre del 2017, diploma de escuela superior, high school o GED, ciudadano de los Estados Unidos, tener licencia de conducir sin delitos y sin estar convicto clase A o clase B. No tener tampoco violencia doméstica y se añade puntos si usted es veterano o vive en New Haven. Solicitar en línea la aplicación en policeapp.com. Gracias. Hasta la semana que viene cuando escuchen esta propuesta. El programa ¿Qué pasa? Con Norma Rodríguez Reyes, señoras y señores, nuestra host de lujo. Así que demos gracias a Dios y chao. Hasta la semana que viene. Bye bye.